Cooper Webb, and I choose OGO.
I'm Christian Craig.
I'm Dean Wilson.
I'm Aaron Plessinger.
I'm Jerry Martin.
I'm Nate Thrasher.
I'm Shane McElrath.
I'm Hunter Lawrence.
My name's Jet Lawrence.
I'm Jordan Smith.
I'm Talon Hawkins.
Stargate Hampshire.
I'm Hayden Deegan.
I'm Colt Nichols.
And I choose OGO.
And I choose OGO.
And I choose OGO.
I'm Tom Bial. I choose OGO.
And I choose OGO.
And I choose OGO.
I'm Jalen Ferrangis.
And I choose OGO.
It was pretty eventful. I knew I couldn't go out without a bang, and heat race, I did just that. I started out front. Chase was really giving me the work, and I decided to take a detour. It wasn't a nice one, but I took it, and we made it. We still made it to the main, 9th place and 18th place. And if we were going straight out of the tunnel, I would have got like a mile long hole shot, I think. But unfortunately, we had to turn left. I overshot the corner, tried to hit the brakes, but it was slick. And yeah, we fought all the way back to second. Chase was riding awesome race like he always does, but you know, me and Justin Hill and Adam had a great battle there about halfway through, and yeah, I'm stoked. Capping the season off with the second place and getting ready for outdoors.
Hey, dude, I'll be honest. I didn't think you were going to come back for this last one. So what was so important to make this happen?
I don't know. Last week just kind of put me in a state of depression, and like, I don't know, I just felt some kind of way with, you know, Coop going out and then Eli going out like that. It was just like, man, I feel for him because I did it the week before. And I don't know, with me not being like physically hurt, I just felt like I owed it to the fans to get out here and do some laps and make it a race. I missed enough races last year that I don't want to miss anymore. It's, I don't know. I just felt like I owed it to the fans and owed it to my team. They didn't have a 450 guy out there. And I'm that guy, so got to show up somehow.
Pretty good. Coming off of a career best last week and still feeling good on the bike. Haven't really changed much. And I think I was 9th in practice, which is the best this year, and then 3rd in the heat race, which was nice. And lap 2 of the main event, got a rear wheel or shroud to my shroud and went down. But last attempt, so we'll take it.
Real quick, take us through the decision to race these last two.
And
I had a big get off.
I mean, I dislocated my shoulder in Nashville, and if I wouldn't have showed up to race, I'd definitely be kicking myself right now. Because, I mean, I've had two really good weekends, my best 2 weekends of the year. So if I would have stayed home, like I said, yeah, I'd have been pissed.
Yeah, weekend was all right. Qualifying was really good. Like, I qualified 6th. I was on the board till about 30 seconds left of the last practice. So that was a big step forward for me because my raw speed really hasn't been that good. But I seem to go faster in the races. And yeah, rest was good. Decent heat race. It was slippery, so I just tiptoed around, got 4th, got a good gate pick. And then, came from probably about 12th, I'd say, to 6th in the main. So it was good. I really wanted to latch on to Dino. But Dino was hitting like all the triples as if it was dry still, like tripling onto the tabletop, tripling before the triple, and I just I felt really good everywhere else, but I just wasn't taking those risks in the rutted surface. So he got away from me, but yeah, you know, I'm safe. Best finish of the year. Brothers on the podium, we gotta share that with, you know, like be down there. And I was looking over and seeing him battle with AC, and like there was a spot on the track I could look over and check him out and see what place he was doing every lap. And seeing he got around AC, and then that pumped me up. And
it was good.
I was pumped. Good season.
It was okay. Just can't get off the gate all year. Had a good start in the main, and then going into the first turn, watched the front. Somebody ran over my leg and sucked me off the back of my bike. Rode around, couldn't get around Tristan Lane, but yeah, ended up 12th. It's a good result, and I'll take it. But it definitely, I definitely think some top 10s were possible the last couple weeks. But being hurt and dealing with all that crap, you know, only having 10 less points than last year, I'll take it.
Where are we going to see you next? Because I hear you may not be going to Canada.
Yeah, so I'm not going to go to Canada. I signed a deal for Worlds that Julian is cool with me doing. So I'm not really sure if I'm allowed to announce it yet. It's all signed and stuff, but yeah, I'm excited to do that.
It was solid. I think I qualified like P21, but I had a pretty good flow on the track since we got some press day yesterday. Had a good flow pretty much all day and felt really good and made it happen straight through the heat. I think I was sixth, seventh, somewhere around there, and then had a pretty good start in the main and rode it in for P9. So career best in the 450, obviously, which is sick. I almost had the career best overall, but I got an eighth on 250, I think, in 2021. So another top 10 to add to my resume, and stoked on it, yeah.
All right. So the Spaniard, Juan Cross.
The old Spaniard now.
The old Spaniard, yes. How old are you?
34 last week.
Oh, okay. All right. Happy birthday. So you just see me flying through the air in the LCQ?
Yeah, I was like going to the 90 before the finish line.
Yeah.
And I saw some guy flying and I was like, what the fuck? And then I saw Alex and said, of course.
Oh, of course? Okay. All right. Yeah, definitely. Yeah, says the guy, John Cross, who gets every hole shot. Every hole shot in Supercross. So how was the main event for you? I mean, like the rain, like did you expect it? It was tough.
Yeah, in the main event, the track was tricky, but...
Did you get tired? You were rolling around.
Yeah, I got tired, but I was tired the second lap.
Yeah.
I mean, you know, like last week in the Fort Rivers race, I couldn't breathe. I did two laps and quit. Bye, Tillman.
So, and is it elevation that messes with you a little bit?
No, we just like got all team sick. Like, in Denver, like, even Bubba had to go to the hospital on Friday.
You and Bubba?
Yeah, we just went together, so that happens.
And yeah, you're gonna get me sick now.
Yeah, maybe. So we went like sick like the last 2 weeks, so I was really happy like to be able to ride and win that, get that LCQ win. Ride the main event.
Struggling year for you a little bit, you know, with like the team sort of that you were on, you know, kind of like parting ways a bit, but good on you, you know, being friends with Bubba and then him giving you, you know, the rest of the year and on his team.
Yeah. It sucks for him because he had hurt, you know, he had like a long recovery now. But he will do it.
Yes.
And but yeah, that was good for me. But yeah, you know how it works. It's difficult when you're private there. Everything with that team, you know, is difficult. So I had to quit. And I was here in the US with no band, no motorcycles, no nothing. I was like, I need to go. So one Bravo Performance, the guys from now in Mexico gave me a bike.
Oh, nice.
Team Faith gave me a ride for Daytona and Indy. But they weren't going to Detroit. But I was like, okay, just take me to Indy and we'll figure out. Then I make the main in Indy and that happened to Bubba, so that was like, for me, I got the ride and still it was like top season.
It only took someone losing their thumb to get you a ride, but I mean, you know, hey, you know, suck.
Yeah.
Yeah. But so, I mean, that's gotta be tough, you know, just sitting here in America, you know, when you're from Spain, no ride, no bike, no nothing.
Yeah.
Dude, like, so what's next for you? Like, do you go back home or?
Yeah, I will go back home and have some rest and I don't know what I was in the summer, maybe some races. You still do like Finland in this race or not?
My wedding is on Finland. So Cade's gonna go, but I'm not going.
To the race?
Yeah,
I'm not going. Are you in Finland?
What's that?
Or is the same date from Finland?
Same date as Finland.
Ah, I thought that you will marry Finland.
No.
I was like, dude, that's
no,
gnarly.
No. Way too many memories. We don't talk about it in Finland, you know what I mean? But, yeah, we need to get Hugo over here to race in the U.S.
Yeah, I tell everybody, but he don't want to spend money. I said, dude, the first year you need to spend money.
He makes more money than everybody. He's in all the movies.
Yeah, I know, but he didn't spend nothing.
Yeah.
He just buy a Mercedes.
Yeah, Salt Lake wasn't too bad. I felt like I rode really well today, was happy with that. Third and free practice. First qualifier, bent my shifter, got that fixed, went back out. Tough block way out in the middle of the track. Hit that, went over the bars. So that was a scrap. Then the last qualifier was P3. So speed was good, heat race, whole shot, P2. That was fine, bit muddy for that one. Main event, just flunked the start. Just disappointing, was riding really well. Got to fifth and AC was just in front of me and hell, so yeah, P5, it was good, but hey, made it 17 rounds, I'm healthy, and yeah, top 10 in points, so we'll take it.
Better sleep for sure. Happy with my riding, bike was awesome, team did awesome. Kenneth Andrew, awesome. Starts were good all day. I honestly started the day pretty crappy. Couldn't get a flow on the track, just didn't feel comfortable. Felt comfortable on the bike, just not riding the track. I felt like couldn't get a flow, couldn't get, got everything down. Short was pretty simple. I just couldn't go fast, I was just slow. Last practice, turned it around. I think I was like 10th overall. Not great, but better. Then we got a bunch of rain right before the heat race and executed the start pretty good. Just about ripped the whole shot. Just drifted. It was so slick, I was scared to get on the brakes too hard. So I ended up like third. Just rode third by myself in the heat race, which was good. And then main event, ripped the start again. Almost had the whole shot, just kind of lost the rear coming around the first turn. Came out like second or third. Ran third for a while. Didn't ride my best, but I was third, so it's cool. Plessinger and Hill got by me, so I was fifth for a little while, and man, just the bittersweet part. I was riding well, felt good, and the lapper literally just stopped in front of me. It messed up in a rhythm and just came to a stop, and I landed right on the back of him, and went down pretty hard, a few bumps and bruises, but I'm okay. More just mad. Yeah, I went down, I think I ended up like 14th or 15th, so just bummed. The goal was top 7, that would have been my best finish of the year. I was like, man, top 5 would be sweet. Got top 5 here like 13 years ago, I posted it. Like 2010, I got top 5 here as well, on the 450. So out there, I was like, man, all right, let's do this. It's doing good. And then, yeah, just should have anticipated a little bit better, I guess, on my part. But yeah, went down, but the effort was there. I felt good. And bummer not to execute it and finish it off, but it's racing, it's part of it.
It's bittersweet. I felt, honestly, so all day during qualifying, I would say this is my best race day overall, all year. My heat race wasn't very good. It's kind of mixed emotions, like not really sure what was gonna happen. Like it was raining, I spun really bad going over the gate, and so it was kind of like I was just riding around the first couple laps trying to figure out what the lines were. Well, there was one line and everybody was single following. So it was definitely a little weird. Once I made some passes, got some clean air, like I felt a lot better and was, I don't want to say playing it safe, but it's like really just filling it out. And I mean, it was a lot different than it was for qualifying, and it was really slippery out there. So for the main, things came around. Like we haven't really gotten any more rain, and the track just continued to dry out. The wind was pretty bad, so that helped with the conditions. But then come main event time, I just had a terrible start, and honestly, I almost stalled on the gate because I didn't rev it high enough, because I've been struggling with the power here at altitude, and it's been so aggressive, and I was just like, well, I'm just gonna barely rev it at all. And then when I went to take off, dude, the bike almost died. I'm like, oh my goodness. So like I was literally last down the straightaway, much less going in the first corner. So honestly, I just tried to keep plugging away, and I raced the whole main event. I raced hard and made some good passes, and just I ended up coming back to seventh, which I mean, for me, I just was happy with my riding. And yeah, I had fun battling out there. Like I felt like, especially last weekend and this weekend, like I've raced, and that's really the first time in my 450 career where I kind of see the progression, and I see the like, okay, I can be competitive. I can race the 450, and a lot of it has to do with setup, and that's really what I've struggled with the most on the 450. So it's been good spending time with the Twisted T HEP Suzuki team, and Chisholm and Kenny. Their wisdom and experience has taught me a lot, and I'm just thankful, man. It's been a lot of fun. I feel like it's went really quick, and man, God's blessed us, and I can hang my hat high because it's been a lot of fun, and I've definitely did everything I could, and yeah, I'm ready for what's next.
All right, big guy, third. Podium, man. We talked about the beginning of the day too.
Yeah. Honestly, I was pretty like let down when it started raining, because it just felt like New Jersey all over again. Where I'm like, I got podium speed, and then it just, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
But you know, ultimately, like the track got really good. Like it got sticky, it got good. I felt like I could push it hard. I seen Adam looking a little, like a little boxy, you know, like maybe he was struggling a little bit, and I'm like, I felt super loose. I'm like, all right, here I come. We got this. AP rode really good. So when he was right there, I'm like, all right, if I get AP first, I'm really golden, because then I think we're gonna get it. All that being said, it was like, then AP got him first, and then I struggled to get him, and then made mistakes, lost AP. But, you know, we got to work our way up. My whole year has been about building blocks, and it's like, you can't go from fourth to second that now, right? You know, yeah. I went 5-4-3. That's cool. You know, yeah. So I'm really, really happy. I think that's the first podium for Team Tedder.
Oh, yeah.
Which is pretty cool. So hopefully after that, they feel like keeping me around. I'd like to think so. Because it's a great program, great people. I'd like to stick around. It's a lot of fun. So, you know, I'm 28. I'm gonna do this for a while. You know, I feel like I'm in my prime right now. I feel like I haven't even reached it. So, just mentally, I feel like I'm far ahead of where I was when I left the sport. Mm-hmm. I just feel like I have a better grasp on what's going on, and you know, a better plan.
Yeah.
And the plan worked out this year big time. It's building up and getting it. So. Yeah, can't wait for, you know, I'm excited to go over to World Supercross. That'll be fun. I don't know what it's gonna be like, you know what I mean? I'm a pretty USA type of guy, but I'm really looking forward to it. And then, you know, the playoff rounds are gonna be a blast. I'm really hoping that we get lined up and hit those too.
How was it?
Unreal. That was awesome night. Won the main event. Just felt super, super good all day, and to end the season like this means a lot. And to be the champion through this season, where it's been up and down, it goes to show the people in my corner, they never stop working, and we'll push through anything.
Dude, how was this week?
This week was a little bit weird, because I was sick most of the week. I only rode once, and I don't know, maybe that's the key, because that was one of my best main events I've ridden since I've been pro. So stoked on it, and looking forward to moving on.